Gordon Kennedy stands in for Jack Dochery in a Mo and gives the oxygen of publicity to Jean-Michel Jarre, Amanda Holden, and riotous roué Leslie Phillips.
It's TV's top celebrity party, and we're on the guest list every Saturday evening. Stars as you've never seen them before in the oldest battle of them all.
Between the boys and the girls.
It must be Party Central, the one Saturday night date you can't afford to miss. Catch the fever Saturdays at 6:55 here on 5.
The new Renault Megane Scenic. It talks your language.
Persil has a special stain release system to get clothes brilliantly clean. Whether you like it or not, Persil's new stain release system is nothing short of brilliant.
All set for your interview.
I really wanted to wear this, but look, it's so delicate. What can I do?
Bleach will fix it.
What? Bleach will ruin it.
Don't worry. It's a gentle bleach called Ace. It's not like normal bleach. It's for all your laundry, even delicate things like this. Cover the stain, but don't let it dry. Pop the rest in the machine with your detergent, and away you go.
Wow! Ace job!
Let's hope it leads to an ace job for you.
New Ace, the safest type of bleach for all your laundry, even delicate.
Scenic. It talks your language.
Just one thing in the way of Jean-Claude Van Damme and the kickboxing world championship. And it's bald and 10 foot high.
You're going to fight Tom Paul?
Yeah.
Can you believe it?
First you must learn how to do it.
How many times do I have to tell you? Punch is a punch, kick's a kick.
Simple. The movie premiere Kickboxer, Saturday at 10 on 5.
Nick Hancock and Lee Evans remember the Comedy Store later. But we visit another great venue, the Whitehall Theatre first.
11 o'clock, I'm Dahlia Raphael. Manchester Airport protesters claim a leaked report proves that the plans for a second runway are a waste of money. They say it shows that traffic is decreasing at the airport, but the CAA told Five's Geeta Gudamurthy that it was inaccurate.
The figures are wrong in terms of what happened anyway, but the fundamental
thing... But these are produced by the civil aviation authority.
Doesn't matter who produces them, if they're wrong, they're wrong. Manchester Airport did not have a 20% fall in charter traffic last year.
Unscrupulous estate agents have been told to put their house in order or face being kicked out of the trade. The Office of Fair Trading said the buoyant housing market has led to some agents failing in their duties. All-party talks began today at Stormont with Northern Ireland Secretary Mo Molum calling for the sides to find a way of moving forward. Sinn Féin turned up for the talks, but they were barred because of the lack of an IRA ceasefire. Youngsters are to be given extra schooling in the summer months on a voluntary basis. The government's setting up pilot summer literacy schools designed to give children who just left primary school extra help with reading and writing. England footballer Teddy Sheringham's been granted a transfer request by his club Spurs. Sheringham claimed he wanted a new challenge. Liverpool are among the favourites to sign the Spurs striker. The weather tomorrow, mainly dry and sunny again, but some showers to the south. Temperatures from 16 to 24 degrees. I'll be back with more news after midnight.
Tomorrow night on Five, we pick up on what makes penguins nervous. Whatever calamity they face, they always seem to
take it all in their waddling stride.
Stick around for the great gardening game at 8, when our competitors race against the clock to solve some perennial problems.
Teams, your time is up.
And then it's time to dive deep beneath the headlines.
Tonight on 5 News, landmines cost as little as £2 to make.
There are some real dangers.
Good night.
Our movie at 9 finds certain issues too close to home in Family of Strangers.
We adopted.
I think I'm your daughter. I don't have a daughter.
And then...
Welcome to Tibbs and Fibs.
The medical quiz which...
is currently being tested on animals.
Rats!
Which two Doctor Who share the same surname?
All of them.
Well, whoever you are, beam into Channel 5's TARDIS of great viewing tomorrow night from 7.
As someone once said, it's good to talk. Even when Jack's away, it's good.
From the Whitehall Theatre, London, please welcome your host for one night only, Mr. Gordon Kennedy!
Thank you very much. Just for the regular fans of that joke. Good evening and welcome to the Jack Dochery Show with guest host Gordon Kennedy.
Me.
And in case you're wondering, Jack's fine. It's just no slaphead day on Channel 5. And tonight my very hairy guests will be rising British actress Amanda Holden, French synthesizer maestro Jean-Michel Jarre, and comic legend Leslie Phillips. The kids this show in the stoter category. Plus, I'll finally get to tell you that anecdote that Jack wouldn't let me tell you last week. Now, I've assured Jack that I'll be true to the hallowed traditions of the Jack Dochery Show, and there is no way I will use it as a vehicle for my obsession for Scottish country dancing. Having said that... I feel so much better. Anyway, on to the news. And the news this week is full of people who made stacks of money out of the lottery and have got absolutely no shame. But enough about me. On to the show. Now, I'm starting off tonight with my royal news and Princess Diana's gowns are up for auction. There's a Christina Wilson one she wore for parties, the David Emmanuel one she wore for official engagements, and the NHS Now and one she wore for heart bypass operations. Yeah. Ooh. The man that made them, then, obviously. And according to the latest rumours, drag queens are lining up to buy them. Now, what on earth is a drag queen going to look like with one of Di's cast-offs? Camilla Parker Bowles, I suppose. Anyway, sports news now, and yes, I know, England won. Well, bloody done, England, yes. But more importantly than that, Teddy Sheringham has been criticised in the papers. He booked into a hotel in the Midlands, trashed his room, had a water fight, and insulted the staff. Well, that's a disgraceful thing to do. I mean, the guy is earning thousands of pounds a week, and he books into a hotel in the Midlands? Hire a private jet, fly over the Midlands. Back to the lottery, and Heritage Secretary Chris Smith predicts that if Camelot carry on like they are, then the lottery will soon be run by a non-profit-making organisation. So, looks like Channel 5's got the gig then. Big news yesterday, and Baby Spice fell off her shoes and sprained her ankle. Now, when she fell over, apparently one leg went this way and the other leg went that way. Now, it's nothing to do with the shoes. It's just an automatic reaction whenever a Spice Girl's on her back. Good, got there eventually. Now, meanwhile, on to someone else who got tripped up by their 6 inches, Bill Clinton. Now, apparently, he may now offer some money to settle the issue with Paula Jones, the woman who's accused him of sexual harassment. He's not mentioned how much, but he says that if Paula comes to see him, he'd be happy to put down a deposit. And amazingly, also, according to a sworn affidavit from Paula Jones, the president has got an eagle on his penis. My God, that man will shag anything! That's better. Right. Hello, Richard.
Hi, Gordy.
How you doing? Great to see you.
Right.
Yeah?
All right, yeah.
Yeah? Have a good weekend?
I had a fantastic weekend.
Great.
Had a barbecue and Phil and Jane came over.
Oh. Now, do you remember Phil and Jane and their barbecue?
I know. Another sausage, brother.
Another sausage. Yeah. Oh, listen, we better save our nattering to after Richard. Okay. So let's be professional, okay?
Yeah.
So could you just pretend that I'm Jack?
Yeah, I can do that, yeah.
Richard Allen, ladies and gentlemen. Cheers. Well, I must admit, I'm a big fan of Jack's show, but there's always been one ingredient missing. The missing link that can turn a good chat show into a great chat show. It's just a little innovation, but I think it's important. Nibbles, ladies and gentlemen. Nibbles. Oh, yeah, we've got drinks, but I think this show needs some nibbles. Oh, yes, I think this will work. And don't forget, they laughed at Archimedes when they introduced nibbles in his chat show. Yeah. Excuse me a second. I'm just looking for money. What's this? Oh, dear, look at that. Some job applications. Look at that. Look, there's one for a traffic warden, one for a car park attendant, one for an anything at all, and they've all been rejected. Dear. Oh, dear. Now, this is really very sad. This is Jack's mirror. No. You're deceiving no one, Jack. Very sad, but true. But anyway, now it is time to say hello to my first guest. And it's not just hello, but it's a hello. You'll have seen him in Carry On films. He's been a doctor in the house. He's even inspired several songs by the Divine Comedy. He's one of the most loved British comedy actors. Lock up your daughters. In fact, lock up your mums. Lock up anything female that moves. Because, ladies and gentlemen, it's Leslie Phillips. Right there, sir. Right there. Please, take a seat. Yes, There you are, Leslie. Little well, drink to wash it down. What
hello,
do you think of it?
Hello. well.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
All night. We'll yes. Do hello and goodbye.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Hello. Thank you. Yeah, I can't help it.
Can you say it any other way, or is it very much?
I'll try.
Okay, well let's try it. Now I know it says in your research that you're a big fan of Margaret Thatcher and Pamela Anderson.
Which bits?
that was going to be my next question. but we won't go into that. Okay, well let's just try it. If you imagine that I'm these following people and you say hello to me, we'll see if your hello changes. First of all, let's see Margaret Thatcher. Say how's Margaret Thatcher. How would you say her? I'd say hello. What would you say?
Darling.
Okay, what about Pamela Anderson?
Oh, my God. Well, I mean, I think I'd notice her.
Now, your acting career started when you were 10 years old.
Oh, yes.
I don't realize that. And you were acting with Rex Harrison when you were 17? Am I right in saying that?
Yes, I was in a play with him when I was 16, I think.
16. What was he like to work with? Because he's a notoriously difficult man to get on with.
Well, they say that. He was quite... He lived up to his name. He was Sexy Rexy. He was quite sexy.
But apparently, again, I read this in the research, that you were one of the few people that Rex Harrison trusted alone with his girlfriend at the time. Is that right?
Oh, yes, yes.
That's surely a tragic, a tragic bad judgment on the part of Rex Harrison.
Not at all. I'm very,
oh, we'll
very
let the fruity kid in the room of all.
I'm very trustworthy, actually. No, no, no.
Good?
The girlfriend you're talking about was Kay Kendall.
All right. So really?
Now, I was playing opposite Kay Kendall in a film in Hollywood called Les Girls with Gene Kelly and Mitzi Gaynor. And Kay Kendall. I played Kay's husband. And she was then married to, well, I think they were married. She was married to Rex Harrison.
So did you have a stage kiss?
No.
Right. Just off stage?
No, we shook hands.
Actually. Oh, I see. Oh, was that sort of play? Darling, I think we should get married, certainly. I'm checking it. Yeah. Okay. Now, you're now touring with the RSC.
Mm.
Why?
Well, I think it's something I've always wanted to do. And in the last sort of 20 years, I've done a few of the classics, you know?
Right.
And in the RSC, I'm playing Falstaff in Merry Wives of Windsor, and I'm playing in a Tennessee Williams play.
All right. How does Falstaff say hello? Does he say hello?
No, he doesn't, actually. I wouldn't dare say hello. I think Shakespeare would turn his grave.
I've got a favour to ask you. Actually, we are, as you can see, we have a live audience here, and we entice our audience onto the show by then phoning up the Jack Dochery Show hotline ticket line,
yeah,
which is an answer phone. Mm-hmm. And the message at the moment is a little lackluster, to say the least. So we would really appreciate it if you would, in fact, record the answer phone message for the Jack Dochery Show ticket hotline. Would you be prepared to do that? The script's
absolutely
written down there for you. It's very simple, and I'll just press the record button here, and then
I think I need my glasses.
Yes, no, please put your glasses on.
Yeah, well, right. No, that's that.
Yeah,
all right,
it goes
go
in
ahead,
there.
Go on.
And I'll tell you when to go.
Right.
Hang on a second. Go.
Hello. Thank you so much for ringing the Jack Dochery Show ticket hotline. I would like to take down your particulars. Say. So please, could you leave your details after the little beep?
Fantastic. Thank you very much.
Right.
You did the answer for me, sir. Okay. Join me after the break when my guest will be one of Britain's brightest young actresses, Amanda Holden, and the James Brown of electronic music, Jean-Michel Jarre. And I will at last tell you my anecdote. At last. They can't stop me now. This anecdote will be free. Justice! See you after the break.
Gentlemen, in the Mojave Desert at 0900, we found these.
Normal citron sexos? No. Notice this color. Nothing we've ever seen before. The name's a little too unusual. This Desire's got a CD player, power steering, electric windows, and sunroof, plus 2 years free insurance. We think they're replicants, gentlemen. It's a phenomenon.
The Citroen Summer Phenomenon. Now that's something you don't see every year.
Yet their attempt to replicate a human is laughably unrealistic.
250 years into the future, the world is on the edge of destruction, and the only way to save it...
Okay.
...is to find the fifth element. Special previews this Saturday and Sunday, and at cinemas everywhere from June 13th. Bruce Willis, The Fifth Element.
Some people like their hair to just stay still.
I want mine to move.
The actual freedom of dance is lovely. My hair is all part of the movement. Rehearsals every morning, performance every evening. Wash and go is great because actually when I've used it, I can run my fingers through my hair completely.
Wash and go contains a conditioning system that smooths and separates each hair strand.
And I love the way it moves. It's definitely possible for hair to dance.
People on the go, wash and go.
I like to wash my hair and I like to go.
Well, security and protection are the main things. Plus, you're in a hot club. You want to feel dry and comfortable, and you don't want to have anything else in your mind. You want to be out having a good time. So I gave Always a go, and it worked amazingly. It really was a surprise.
Look, it's amazing how much these 3 millimeters can absorb. The secret, the dry weave top sheet, and the ultra absorbent core, which work together to lock away the liquid. The result, the pad stays fresh and dry. Proof that you are really protected.
And with Always, I am secure, I am protected, and I am comfortable, so that covers every aspect.
Relax, you're ultra-protected.
Flash mildew stain remover. Just squeezing its boosted bleach formula makes shifting even nasty mildew easy. Flash does the hard work, so you don't have to.
The powerful story of a woman's search for her roots.
Everybody has lied to me.
Family of Strangers, Wednesday at 9 on 5.
Oh my God. Wait, the shoes. Yeah? I bought them off Baby Spice this morning. Big feet, though, elegant Nespa. Yeah. What do you think? I don't know what the problem is. They're really easy to walk in. Okay, here we are. Anyway, welcome back to the Jack Dochery Show. Jack is off work today, so I, Gordon Kennedy, am standing in for him. Brilliantly, it says here. Anyway, here's a note from Jack's mum explaining why he isn't here. It is. It says, "Dear Jack Dochery Show, please may Mummy's little soldier be excused being on the show today, as he has a verruca and lost his plimsolls, and his little brother scribbled all over him, and he's got a temperature of 1,000,000, and a volcano erupted in the garden, and there's been a turn on the pound, and he's dead. So don't ring him, he'll be fine by tomorrow. Yours sincerely, Mrs. Jackie McDocherty." There you are. That's his letter. Now, earlier, I introduced a new innovation to the show, nibbles. But what this show needs to take it into the super classy league is cocktails. Just mix them up. Whoop. There we are, and voila. See? So let's see if that's sophisticated enough for my next guest. It's a young actress who's poised on the brink of stardom. She's gone from a small part in EastEnders to a huge part in Channel 5's sketch show, We Know Where You Live. And she's about to appear in the new Julie Walters film, Intimate Relations. Please give her a larger than big welcome, Amanda Holden!
Hello.
Please, sit down. Oh. Amanda,
oh,
Amanda, Amanda. Yes, please, have
lovely.
A shot
I'll
of that.
Blue one, so
do you like a blue lagoon?
Outfit.
Classy dame. Classy
Thank
dame.
Thank you.
Lovely. That's the one with alcohol in it, unfortunately.
Oh, is
anyway.
It?
Yeah, no, no, you have that one. Cheers. Your health.
Cheers, darling.
I won't attempt to drink
I
it.
I think I'll drink that, no.
No, Amanda.
Yes.
We know where you live.
Do you?
Yes, I do actually know where you live. But that's another story, Amanda, for another show. Now, I read somewhere that after 13 shows you were on your knees. Now, was that just cast bonding or were you very, very tired?
I was very tired, but we did want to do a second series, so yes, I was on my knees.
You are? Ah.
I was begging. Slightly. You understand.
Yes, no, I'm sure
else.
You all understood that. Right, where else do you think you're in? Okay, before we go any further, shall we just see a little clip of We Know Where You Live?
And that was Kim's video of her holiday in Corfu. Next week on the Incredibly Real Holiday Show, we'll be looking at pensioners Alfie and Mabel Smith's video of their holiday in Southsea. Here's a sneak preview.
So, were you surprised?
I'll give you that tenner later, okay?
Were you surprised that people laughed? Why are you surprised?
No, I wasn't surprised at all. It's a very, very funny show. Very good. Very late on. Very late.
It received mixed reviews.
Yeah.
When
they
it came
said
out.
It was hit and miss, but that the six of us were good. So I can handle that.
Anyway, second point of note is that you're married to Les Dennis.
Yes, that's correct.
Yes. I mean, what's it like to live with someone like Les Dennis? I mean, for instance, here's a scenario. Say you get dressed up for the evening, you go out somewhere
in
posh,
my sailor suit.
Yeah. And you come down the stairs in your sailor suit. Now, is Les very straightly? Does he actually say yes I like it or no I don't, or does he have to go out into the street and ask 100 people? And then you'll come back
if
in and go,
if he sees something, I was just going to do that.
Sorry.
No, he's very straight. He's very quiet, Les is. I'm the gobby one in the relationship. He's very quiet and very charming. And
is he?
Yes.
Oh, I don't want to hear that.
You know him?
Yes, no, I do.
Hey, you going into Joseph and his amazing coloured dream coat? This is what this is here.
No, that's a pink shirt.
Oh,
that
right.
one. And a matching pink tie.
It's lovely.
Actually, thank you. Do you like it?
Like a little shrimp.
And look, I've got matching pink cufflinks. It's just to match my sunburn, actually, because I was out in the sun a little too long.
They look like my nipples, those cufflinks.
Do they?
Yeah.
Apparently. Really?
Yeah.
Ooh.
I'll show you later.
You should see my belt, the buckle of my belt. Sorry.
It's all right,
that's
darling.
Not.
That's
all right. That's so it's right about this time, generally when we're interviewing someone as charming as yourself, that we sort of Jack sort of talks around it, and I'm going to come straight to it. I'd like some intimate, exclusive gossip on you and Les, so we can sell it to the press. Something that's never been told before.
Les has a wonderful habit of farting tunes. He can fart any tune. He lies on his back, he sucks air up his ass, and he can fart any tune. It's like Name That Tune.
You know,
I mean, he could do a whole new program. He could have taken over from Tom O'Connor and done Name That Tune and farted. I very nearly asked him to fart Here Comes the Bride for our wedding, actually.
Except that you'd have been going against the wind, presumably,
yeah.
coming up the aisle. So you'd have got a bit of, you know, the veil would have been...
Yeah.
Do you know, it's funny you should say that, because I know that. Because when I worked with him, there was one day... He
it's
farted dead cars to me. It was the most astonishing thing. And interestingly enough, I knew that. And I thought that you might know that. So,
yes, I'm very well aware of that.
I'd quite like to put your knowledge of your husband's bottom to the test, if I may.
All right.
Because our researchers, they've spared no expense at all. They've scoured the world and they've recorded three famous showbiz celebrities farting a tune. And I challenge you, Amanda Olin, to name that arse, okay? So, could we have celeb number A, please? I'm sure you can all tell it's Here Comes the Bride, obviously.
That was too loose for Liz.
Well, that's what's
his
number
are
A.
A bit tighter
Here's
than that.
Number B. Okay, that's B. And here's celeb C. Okay?
It's number three. C.
You reckon it's number three?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, you're wrong. Number three was in fact Wesley Snipes.
No!
And Les was in fact number A.
Hair bomb's not that loose.
And for those of you... that day it was. I don't know, you know why, whatever. But it was.
Steady.
He was, you know, he wasn't as stressed as maybe normally was. And for those of you watching at home, maybe that, you know, you want to know what number B was, it was, of course, Emma Thompson. Great.
Thanks
for coming on. Coming back on if you get recommissioned for We Know Where You Live. Come back and chat to us.
We will.
Ladies and gentlemen, Amanda Holt. I can't wait any longer. Now is the time, finally, to tell you my incredibly amusing and engaging anecdote. Now, I came on the show all last week, and I was primed, ready to tell it to Jack, and here's what happened.
It's right. The most incredible thing that's ever happened to you.
Most incredible. Right, yeah, okay, well, I was on my way to work one day.
Yeah, I'm sorry, we're out of time there, Gordon. Can you come back and finish the anecdote tomorrow?
That's right, okay, right. Well, I was driving my car on the way to work.
I'm sorry, I'm getting the wind-up sign. I'm sorry, we're out of time. What was happening? The most incredible thing ever happened to you.
Right, okay, well, I was driving my car on my way to work.
Oh, my God, I'm terribly sorry, I'm just being wound up. We're out of time once again. I don't...
And now, here is the anecdote. I've forgotten it. No, it's okay. I've remembered it again. Here it goes. My anecdote. I was coming to work one day, and then I got to work. Come on. Well, it's not Peter Ustinov, I know, but it gives us a chance, please. It was either that or doing Scottish country dancing again. Right, now, regular viewers to the Jack Dochery Show will know that this is the only show in Britain to have access to the literally hundreds of millions of literally digital TV channels. Literally. Obviously, the explosion of choice means more good. And my personal favorite channel is channel 678-555-555-555-555.
Hello, welcome to the face-pulling channel. No fuss, no messing, just 24 hour a day pulling faces. Let's cut the chat and pull faces.
Wow! Now, my final guest is the godfather of synthesizer technology and is world famous for his spectacular laser shows, which regularly play to audiences of over a million. Although, he's no chance of that tonight, obviously, and it's just a shame he can't spell oxygen. Please welcome Jean-Michel Jarre! Jean-Michel, first of all.
Yes.
Nibbles? Cocktail?
Oh, great.
And a nice hot wet flannel.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, just a little thing. A little class to the show. Lovely. Now, I've got to start by saying we actually do have something in common because I was at your Docklands 88 concert that you did in London Docklands. Obviously, I didn't realise I was at it. I was just living in a flat in the Docklands, watching Coronation Street. And suddenly it felt like the Martians had landed. There was lasers, it was just going all over the place. You like concerts big. How was that gig to do?
Well, the Wagnerian, the Docklands one.
Wagnerian, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Rain and wind, and it was more like the Atlantic Ocean that night. A storm in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean.
Right, right. No, I mean, I really enjoyed it. I objected to a guy charging me £6 for a Coke in my own kitchen. that aside, it was a good gig. And now, obviously, you know, we're coming towards the millennium. I mean, have you got your millennium concert sorted out? Have you booked the moon?
Never. A more minimalist project for year 2000. Can I show you?
Yes.
It's called the Blue Rabbit. Very minimalist.
You know, that's certainly smaller than most.
No power,
okay.
No electricity, no laser, nothing. Just this, you see.
That's fantastic.
You see, I'm sure that even from your window, the dock fans.
Yeah.
I think can be a hit.
So let me get this right. You're going to do that in front of a million people.
Yeah.
You'll never get out of the place alive. Great. Thank you. Can we leave him there?
Oh yes, sure.
You could just give him a nibble. That's marvellous. Why do you make your concerts so huge? They are enormous. Why do you?
Because
do
at one stage I said to myself, one day I could be smaller. It's what I'm doing now.
Right.
Because actually I'm doing my first indoor tour. I feel like a beginner because after having explored these ways of producing and creating outdoor events, outdoor concerts. Right.
Now your new show, it's apparently cost $15 million to put on. It's got 200 crew. The stage set is 8 stories high, and you're calling that back to basics.
What can I say?
Okay. Well, look, we'll have a look at that clip because we've got a clip of your most recent tour.
So that's right. The show that's going on. Recent tour, recent single. Because
this is the recent single.
Yeah, that's
okay,
right.
Okay. Let's have a look
Oxygen.
At that clip.
You were right. That's from the clip of the tour I'm doing at the moment.
Yeah. Now that track was called Oxygen,
Oxygen
10.
Yes, it's from
which is on your album Oxygen 7
album.
To 12.
That's right.
Which was preceded
7 to 13.
7 to 13.
The new.
And you had an album before called Oxygen 1 to 6.
That's right.
Titles, they're not your big one really, Jean Michel.
No? But it's simple to remember, you see.
Yeah, no, I can see that.
I mean, when you are doing music without lyrics, you don't need like a movie or like a novel. You don't have a specific title for each chapter, right?
Okay.
So it's the same idea.
All right. Now, what was the instrument you were playing in that particular clip there?
This instrument is called the theremin.
Theremin. Right.
And okay. it's
I'm glad you said that because we've got one.
I know.
We've got a small
theremin. Small one.
Theremin here. There you are.
That's right.
I might call it a conversation piece, but it's called a theremin. There you are. So could you now what explain? This is one of the first electronic instruments.
The first one has been done in the 20s by a Russian guy.
Right, but this is the same thing.
And this is the same kind of instrument.
So
can
you play
and
it?
And actually, you have...
Okay.
Most of them, you have two antennas, but like you have... Let's say you have two... One is for the volume, and the other one for the antenna. Mm-hmm. And for the pitch, I mean. And you can have like a...
All right, can you scratch it? That's fantastic. Okay. Right. Yeah, I'll try it. Okay.
Not bad. Are you? That's
hey,
good.
That quite likes abuse.
Are you free on Sunday night? Because I'm playing Wednesday.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Astonishing. Yeah. That was almost a duet, really, wasn't it? Now,
yes.
You were. This is from your new show, but you were one of the first people to play in China, Western musicians to play in China,
yeah.
Right? So
yeah,
you set the standards. So they must have been a bit disappointed when Billy Bragg tapped up with his guitar. Where are the lasers? What happened? Why did you do it? And why were you let in? Why were you the first one to be let in?
I know they asked me in the first place. I mean, just after Mao's time, they played on Chinese radio Oxygen. I mean, the first one.
Yeah. Okay.
And they asked me to go there for a small concert, and then it ended with a tour over there. It was really great. And it's like, I mean, actually playing in China is like really playing on another planet, because these people have no ideas at that time about who the Beatles were, or Kennedy, or Charlie Chaplin, or anything. They've been really cut off for 25 years or 30 years time from basically everything.
Okay.
But very nice audience, very good souvenir.
And when are you playing in this country?
I'm playing in this country, actually.
In London, you're
this
playing?
London, Wembley on Sunday and Monday, but before Glasgow and Birmingham, Manchester by the end of the week.
Okay.
Busy schedule.
Yeah, busy schedule. Good luck with it. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Jean-Michel Jarre.
Thank you.
Jean-Michel Jarre. Terrific. In fact, I have to say, I'm so inspired that I've made my own futuristic instrument, and I spent the entire ad break working in my laboratory to create this. Laser spoons. Thank you. Thank you very much. Right, well, that's just about it. I've been Gordon Kennedy. Thank you for having me. And thanks to all my guests, Leslie Phillips, Amanda Holden, and Jean-Michel Jarre. Jack will be back tomorrow when he'll be talking to Comedy Soprano Jimmy Mulville. And there'll be Young Persons music from the Sneak Pimps. I just hope you can hear all the lyrics. Spoons, take me away. Goodbye.
Stand by for another helping of superior stand-up from that most hallowed of venues, the Comedy Store. Not to mention stories from Lee Evans and Nick Hancock. Stories from Lee Evans and Nick Hancock. I told you not to mention that. Ha, ha, ha!
See the stars letting their hair down in TV's top celebrity party. Night Fever, Saturdays at 6:55 on 5.
I drink Metz because of the schnapps.
Pure filtered schnapps, 5.4%.
I like this bar because the barman and I used to play together as kids.
Because he doesn't know that.
Robbie's the bar if you want the lot. With chocolate even thicker than Spot.
That's your block, man.
Communism meets consumerism in the handover of Hong Kong, fueling the people's desire for advanced consumer goods. There are some consumers, however, who are already one step ahead. Vorsprung Dark Technik, as they whisper in China.
Vanish Liquid removes stains and is safe on colours and delicates. Vanish Liquid, tough on stains, safe on colours and delicates.
Hands can pass viruses to your eyes and mouth. Protect your family from nasty viruses. Use new Detox Surface Spray. Reach for the sword.
The MFI sale, up to 50% off kitchen cabinets. 42 kitchen styles reduced. Great new offers, like this Hygiena Oakland kitchen, complete with oven, hob, extractor, sink taps, worktops, and a dishwasher, all for under £700. So for great new offers, get down to MFI or MFI Homeworks today.
It's as easy as this to know whether you're pregnant or not, thanks to Predictor Home Pregnancy Test. It's so easy, so reliable. Predictor, so simple, you can't go wrong.
Join
Join Captain Stay Dry for the new Huggies treasure hunt, because nothing keeps a pirate drier than Huggies. And all Huggies have stretchy, refastable tabs. They fasten again and again, even with oily hands. Oh, treasure ahoy!
Huggies?
Huggies, there's no drier nappy on the seven seas.
For a motor insurance policy paid by instalments, interest-free, call General Accident Direct on 0800 121 000 tomorrow.
In dressage, first impressions mean so much.
Jane Breedin, British team rider.
I'm looking for perfection, and so are the judges. If I look good, I definitely feel more confident. But that look doesn't last if it rains, because horses and rain create mud. On my whites, it was sometimes very hard to remove the dried-in mud with my old powder. I often had to soak them overnight to try to get them clean. Then I tried Aerial.
Aerial Future emits active oxygen bubbles as it begins to work. It removes dried-in stains like mud better than rival compact brands.
When you trot into the arena looking perfect, all the years of hard work are forgotten. You feel ready to win.
When you demand the impeccable, demand Aerial.
Life has never been easy for Joe, but now it's about to get tough.
You called me a woman.
Just don't start acting like one.
Ruby Jean and Joe, Friday at 9 on 5.
I'm going to tell her.
Oh, Jack.
It's over.
Family misfortunes in family affairs. Weeknights at 6:30 on 5.
And now on 5, it's near the knuckle, below the belt, and in your face. Be warned, it's the Comedy Store.
Anybody here read the news tonight? Not really likely, I suppose. Trevor McDonald's got that job pretty much sewn up, hasn't he?
Oh, are you all right? Yay! Oh, good, that's lovely. I was just wondering, because I was feeling a bit dizzy, and I don't know if it's because I got a cold or if just because I'm blonde.
An old girlfriend of mine said, you are a bit fussy, darling, you're a bit pedantic, a bit of a pedantic sort of bloke. In fact, you're the most pedantic man I've ever been out with. I said, no. I think you'll find I'm the third most pedantic man you've ever been out with.
Indeed. How are you? Thank you very much. My name is indeed Ed Byrne, although you'll probably already know me as Darlene from Roseanne. Okay, yes, very good. Yes, you could have shouted Donald McPhail there, that was very clever. You notice how my one got a bigger laugh, though. There you go. Yeah, that's another thing there. That's why I've got a microphone and you don't. The only time you get a microphone is when they put you on the...